My name is Don Lobb. I guess you could say I've been a career farmer. I grew interested in soil conservation work as a result of some of the soil degradation we saw on our own farm. In fact, on my farm, there was 10 times more soil being moved as a result of tillage than there was from the combined effect of wind and water. The cost of that kind of erosion is huge.
So as an agronomist in Ontario who's heavily involved in measuring soil properties, I think there's tremendous opportunity in using those measurements to manage our soils differently. We've been doing lots of soil mapping. We've also been measuring topsoil depth, and we'll find topsoil depths anywhere from 1 or 2 inches deep all the way to 40 inches deep. The main cause of that is tillage erosion. Typically, we find the most erosion on our steepest slopes, generally at planting, right? Those areas are drier. So we actually get slower uneven emergence from our seeds in those areas because we just can't get them into moisture. We can't plant deep enough in those areas. Because that area is drier, it's gonna uptake less water. We're gonna have less yield potential.
So we've just kind of gone over the crest of the hill, and this is kind of the point where you're going to see tillage equipment is going to really start to the process of tillage erosion, because as it's going downhill, gravity's kind of working against you, really, because as the tillage moves down, there's momentum with the tractor and the equipment going down the hill, and it's tossing that soil down, but gravity's taking it down as well, and obviously the hill's falling out. So the more the topography, the more tillage erosion, the more movement you're going to have each year as it goes down the hill. That, and then once you start getting into the mid-slope area, then it starts to combine with the water erosion, because the water starts to accumulate at the top. There's not much, but then it starts to gather up as you're starting to, the water's moving down the hill slope. And so you can really see the effects of the erosion on the crops in this area, in the mid-slope range here. You can see how we've gone from a fairly decent wheat crop here, and then just dropping off to not much of anything, low straw. The heads aren't near as full as up on the top edge here. So this is when you start to, you can see that. And you can see that across a lot of the landscape here too, on those crests coming down there where there's a really poor wheat quality. And when they harvest, they'll notice that on their yield monitor. We're probably losing about 4 to 8 tons per acre per year. Now that might, what's that mean? I mean, 1 ton of soil, if you spread it over an acre, would only be about, the thickness of a couple pieces of printer paper, really, really thin. But then, so if you got five, that's like 10 sheets of paper, 5 tons per acre, 10 sheets of paper. Now, tillage erosion, it's probably reaching more like 30 to 50 tons per acre in this area, on these steeper slopes. And so now you're talking 30 to 40 sheets of paper. So now it's getting thick. And then you do that every year, and that all adds up. And before you know it, I wouldn't be surprised if we've lost 4 to 6 inches of topsoil in 24, 25 years in this area, and it's moved down the slope.
When you're trying to determine the nature and extent of tillage erosion on your site, there's several diagnostics or things you can look at to verify that's what's going on. One of the first indicators is a growing crop. Here, at the point of harvest, you can see that the wheat height is much lower in this spot right here. The tillering is less dense. There's fewer kernels in the head. The wheat yield is definitely lower. Another one is if you step back and look at the overall site position, that you're dealing with somewhere between a crest and a mid-slope position. And that happens as well. Another is the soil itself. Start looking for drier looking soil, lighter colors. Sometimes there's gravel at the soil surface. And if you do have the luxury of having 10% hydrochloric acid, it will react with lime in the soil.
Tillage erosion through time effectively tries to flatten out your property or flatten out your field. On the other hand, water erosion is kind of doing the opposite thing. So when it makes a cut through a field, it's actually making a groove in your landscape, and so it's actually making it steeper. So the two act differently and end up with different results.
There's a couple management practices that we can change. Spreading organic amendments such as compost or green bin waste from the cities. We spread lots of those on our highly eroded areas to kind of build up the organic matter levels. We don't till those areas anymore. We have the planter technology nowadays that we can maintain the appropriate seeding depth across the field when we're doing no-till and tillage within the same fields.